Okay, there should already be water here somewhere, but I can't see shit. Let there be light. Okay, that's better. Let there be an expanse to separate water from water, and I'll call that sky. Sweet. Let dry ground appear.
Not bad. Not bad at all.
Let the land produce vegetation. Let there be lights in the expanse to separate day and night. I'll call them the sun and the moon and the stars.
Whoa, back up. You created the sun and the moon and the stars after you created light? And you created plants before you created the sun?
Yeah, so?
Nothing. Forget it.
Moving on. Let us create the fish of the sea and the animals of the land of all their different kinds.
But wait a minute. You created this endless universe with millions of galaxies and with billions upon billions of stars in each galaxy, with countless planets and trillions of different life forms on Earth, and you did this all just for man? I mean, that seems a little wasteful, doesn't it?
Shut the hell up, Jeffrey.
God, I really don't get this.
It's not that hard to figure out. Round peg, round hole. Catch up, Jeffrey.
Yeah, but why would they even want to do this?
To make more people, of course. I don't want to have to create everybody. Also, it'll feel really, really good.
That's a good idea. If you want them to love you, well, you should make them happy. Good idea, God.
Yeah, I know. I thought of it. I'm gonna call it sex. Oh, they're really gonna love me down there, Jeffrey. They're even gonna scream out my name when they do it.
Yeah, well, that's why you're making them, isn't it? You're making them to, you know, love you.
Well, yeah, but it sounds kind of sad and pathetic when you say it like that. Well, okay, it's been a hard few days, but I got the universe created. Now all I gotta do is create man.
So, God, how are you gonna make this dude anyway?
Simple. I'll use a handful of dirt. Hang on. See, there he is. I made him in my image.
Your image? Yeah, right. I think you're a little bit too generous downstairs, if you know what I mean.
Jeffrey, shut the hell up.
Okay, God, it's been a long few days, but you made the universe, and you made Earth, and the sun, and the moon, and the land, and the water, and the plants, and animals, and man. I guess all you got left now is to make a woman, right?
Not so fast, Jeffrey. First, I want to, put a tree of knowledge down there in the Garden of Eden.
Tree of knowledge, what's that do?
Oh, it'll fuck everything up royally. Big time.
Well, why would you put that there? I thought you wanted these people to love you.
Yeah, but it'll be funny to watch them fuck up, won't it?
I don't know. I don't get this, God. You go through all this trouble to make this perfect being, and then you put this tree down there that's gonna fuck them up? What's the point? I mean, I just don't get this.
Oh, you'll be thanking me later when you're laughing your ass off. Adam, listen up. I'm about to bring you a helper. But first, I wanted to talk to you about something. You see that tree over there with the really delicious looking fruit? That is the tree of knowledge. Do not, I repeat, do not eat a piece of fruit from that tree. If you so much as touch a piece of fruit from that tree, I swear by me, you'll die. You will surely die. You hear me talking to you, boy?
So, God, what are you gonna make a woman with? Another handful of dirt?
Nah, you ain't got one of Adam's ribs.
Ouch, that's gonna hurt. Why the hell would you do that?
Relax, Jeffrey, I'll wait till he's sleeping.
Oh!
Yeah, I know. Remember what I said. Now have fun.
Hey Adam, try a piece of that fruit. Please? Pretty please?
Do not. Okay, my work is done here. Think I'll take the day off.
Let me put it this way. If you don't eat a piece of that, then you don't get a piece of this. Gad, you said round peg, round hole, right?
Yeah, why?
Well, I guess you shouldn't have gave her those other holes then, 'cause they're doing it wrong.
Ah, shit.